Have you ever wondered what would happen if you applied heat to a zinc battery? What about a 9-volt alkaline battery? What about an 18650 lithium-ion battery? What about an earbud or AirPod battery? What about Apple AirPods themselves? Well, in this video, we're going to find out. Do not do this. Heating up a battery or AirPods can be extremely dangerous. I'm doing it so you don't have to. Before we start, a quick reminder for you to hit subscribe so I can keep making interesting content. This is a creme brulee torch. Consumer air butane torches can develop flame temperatures up to approximately 1430 degrees centigrade or 2610 degrees Fahrenheit. Zinc-based batteries are very commonly used, mainly due to their low cost. Heavy-duty zinc batteries are generally composed of a zinc chloride electrolyte mixed with a small amount of ammonium chloride. Although I've been heating this battery up for quite a while now, nothing much seems to be happening. Manufactured in their billions every year, alkaline batteries are the world's most popular household battery. They use an alkaline electrolyte of potassium hydroxide. In this test, the battery's outer case started glowing red, and potassium hydroxide started leaking out from the base of the battery. Lithium-ion is the most popular rechargeable battery chemistry in use today. They power everything from mobile phones to electric cars. They consist of lithium metal oxides in the positive electrode and carbon in the negative electrode. Lithium salts dissolved in organic carbonates make up the electrolyte. Heating up an 18650 can be fairly explosive. An AirPods or earbuds battery is a scaled-down version of the lithium 18650. As such, heat would reach its core far more quickly, as this test shows clearly. Contained within all earbuds and Apple AirPods are rechargeable lithium-ion batteries. After the tiny battery is installed, the AirPods outer shell is sealed tight with glue. This adds a different dynamic to the test, one that is evident once sufficient heat is applied by the sight and sound of the resulting explosion. You wouldn't want that going off in your ear. With a zinc battery, nothing drastic happened. Zinc batteries are not flammable, nor are they subject to thermal runaway. If I heated up the alkaline battery for much longer, pressure would have caused the battery to rupture. Then the hydrogen would have mixed with oxygen and the battery would have exploded. Once heat penetrated the lithium-ion battery's casing, the 18650 both exploded violently and emitted toxic gases. Far smaller than a lithium-ion 18650 cell, the AirPods battery exploded relatively quickly, as was expected. Once heat had penetrated the AirPods casing, the battery within it ignited, and the AirPods exploded violently. There we have it, experimentation done. Remember, do not do this yourself. Thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe, hit the notification bell, and check out the other videos on my channel.